ready or not.
Come out of this. Somebody's going to the NBA. Somebody's going to the NFL. That next team is going to go just a little bit further because of Mike. In the name of Jesus, somebody's marriage is going to get better just as a result of talking to him. Just as a result of his counseling, you're going to get better. Something good, is going to come out of this. So I come this morning, and as I begin to close, I've seen the lightning flash.
I've seen the thunder roar.
I've heard the thunder roar.
Thank you, Jesus.
I heard doubt trying to conquer your mind. But I heard the thoughts of Jesus telling this church, don't give up. Yeah. Don't give in. Don't complain. Just thank him.
Thank you, Jesus.
Fight on. Live on. Serve on. He promised never to leave us nor forsake us. Praise him for your healing. Come on, somebody give me praise. Praise him for your deliverance. Praise him for your breakthrough. Let everything that have breath. Praise the Lord. When the flowers stop coming, when the relatives go back home, when the cakes and pies are no longer being baked, hold on to God's unchanging hand. There will be times you're riding in the car and you will hear Mike sing these voices as if he was sitting right next to you. And it will tickle the whole fiber of your being. And there will be times when you leave here that you will pray and cry. There will be times that you pray and cry. There's going to be times when you pray and cry. But I hear God saying, stand. He will keep you in perfect peace whose mind is stayed on him. There's going to be bumps in the road. But stand. It's going to be hard sometimes. But stand. It may feel like you want to give up. But stand. Oh, what a friend we have in Jesus. All of our grief and sins to bear. Oh, what a privilege it is to carry everything to God in prayer. Family, you hold on to one another. Pick up the phone and check on Deborah. It's rough building a life with someone and suddenly find yourself alone. Wait on the Lord and be of good courage. He shall strengthen thine heart. Wait on the Lord. Again, I say wait. Not only does God know the final verdict, but God knows what you're facing right now and what we will face. But my Bible says, now faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. We might not see how we're going to make it right now, but my faith assures me that we will. The songwriter penned these words, blessed assurance, Jesus is mine. Oh, what a foretaste of glory divine. Bless you today. And you might be here today, and although we preached and although we talked about Mike and how he lived for the Lord and how we talked about Jesus, you might not know him. Amen. And as I spoke in my sermon, that if you were to die today or tomorrow, where would you spend eternity? The question still stands. And you want to know something? I got saved at a funeral. And I can remember back in my youth selling drugs, using drugs, drinking, smoking, Percocets, Xanax, oxycodone, before you knew about oxycodone. I can remember thinking to myself, I don't know where I'm going. But I wanted to be sure on that day when I left that funeral after all of the tears, after all of the crying, I wanted to be sure that my soul was secured. And before I knew it, I found myself, they didn't even say come down, they just said raise your hand. I found myself walking down the aisle. So I'm just going to ask you today to raise your hand. If that's you, if you don't know where you spend eternity, amen, because I want to warn you, amen, as the Lord leads and guides, that I don't want you to make a permanent decision for your temporary problem. Whatever you're looking for, this is the most important decision in your life. Because after you close your eyes to this world, no more decisions to be made. You got a chance right now to know Jesus. Is there one?